Now, in this lecture, we will discuss about three more operators. And those three operators are concatenate operator, conditional operator, and replication operator. So we will see about all these three operators. Now, concatenate operator. This operator concatenates two or more vectors to create a large vector. So what it does, it concatenates or it add two or more number of vectors to create a larger vector. So the symbol of this operator is here, and there is this curly bracket. Now inside the curly bracket, now see one more thing, any number of operands can be used. Now to distinguish one operand from another operand, a comma symbol is to be used, right? So here you can see this comma symbol is there. Before this you can use first operand, after comma you can use second operand, right? And if you are having more number of operands, then you can write in this way, operand number one comma operand number two comma operand number three comma operand number four. So suppose if we are having four operands, then we can write these all these four operands inside this curly bracket. And this operator, what it will do, it will concatenates all these four operands, right? And it will form a new larger vector, right? So here all these operands are vector, so it will concatenate this. So we will see the example how this happens. Okay, so now in this example, let A and B are two 3-bit vectors and D is a 6-bit vector. So now this statement is written here. So this is one statement. Now in this statement, D is equal to inside the curly bracket A comma B is written. So here this is an example of concatenate operator, because we are having two curly brackets and inside this we are having two operands. Here A is operand number one and B is operand number two. So in concatenation, what will happen, A and B will be added, these two vectors will be added. So since A is 3-bit vector and B is 3-bit vector, so when these will be added, so it will become 6-bit vector, and that 6-bit vector will be assigned to D, and D is already declared as 6-bit. So in this way we can add or we can concatenate the operands. So if we have written this statement, then the result will be 6-bit vector and it will be D is equal to A2, A1, A0. These three bits are, these are the three elements of vector A. Then the elements of vector B is B2, B1 and B0. So now total six elements has been created due to concatenation. element number 1 is b0, element number 2 is b1, element number 3 is b2, element number 4 is a0, element number 5 is a1, and element number 6 is a2. So these values will be assigned to D. Okay. We'll take another example. Now in this example, E is equal to, again we are using here concatenation operator. Now here it is written 3 tick B 1 1 1. The meaning of this is, here this B, this indicates the base of the number. It indicates base of number, right? And here we have written B, so B means it is binary number. It is binary. And before B we kept the tick, and before this I kept a constant integer value 3. So this 3 indicates number of bits. Okay, so number of bits are 3 or number of bits are 3, and these are binary numbers, and the value of these 3 bits are 1, 1 and 1, right? So, and now suppose if you write 2 tick B, so this means that 2 binary value we can write now, and those values can be 0, 1, or it can be 1, 0 or 1, or whatever it may be, but you can mention only 2 binary value, right? And in place of B, if you write 2 tick H, so here H means the base of the number is hexadecimal, right? It is hexadecimal. And so 2 tick H, this means 2 elements of hexadecimal can be written here. So suppose we can write 9A. Okay, so here 9 is considered as a hexadecimal number, which is equal to 1001 in binary, and A is considered as 0110, right? So in place of writing this 1001101010, you can write it as 9A, and here you mention this is a hexadecimal number, and tick 2 means 2 hexadecimal number you can write. Okay, so now here you just see, so now in this particular example we are having 3 operands. This is operand number 1, then A, this is the operand number 2, and then 2 tick B 00, this is the operand number 3. And this concatenate operator, now what it will do, it will create an array of how many bits? Operand number 1 is having 3 bits, 1, 1, 1. Operand number 2 is A. Already I mentioned here A is a 3 bit vector. So 3 bits for A, that is A 2, this is 1 bit of the A, then A 1, then A 0. This is third bit of A. Okay. And then the third operand is of 2 bit. You see here what is written, 2 tick B 0 0. So this means two numbers of base binary can be written here, and those numbers are 0 0. So this is 0 and 0. So due to this concatenate operator, we get a new number. And how many bits are there in that number? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. An array of 8 bit is created, right? Array of 8 bit is created, and this 8 bit array is assigned to E, right? So E is also, and E should also be declared as 8 bit number. Right, then see here the both sides must have the same length, right? So here, since at the right hand side, we have 8 bit number, that's why in the left hand side also we should have a 8 bit vector. So A should be 8 bit, right? So see, the result is 8 bit vector E, and its value will be 1 1 1, A2 A1 A0 0 0. So this is the application of concatenate operator. Now we see another operator, conditional operator. This operator assigns one of the two values depending on a conditional expression, right? So depending upon certain condition, out of two values one value will be assigned. Okay, so the symbol of this operator is this, a question mark and colon. Okay. So number of operands for this operator is 3. So you see the syntax of this operator. Conditional expression has to be written first, then question mark, after this true expression, colon, first expression. So it has 3 operand. Conditional expression is considered as first operand, true expression is considered as second operand, and false expression is considered as third operand. So here, depending upon the conditional expression, right, either this true expression or false expression, any one will be assigned, that value will be assigned. So here you can see, if the conditional expression evaluates true or 1, then the value of true expression is chosen, otherwise the value of first expression is chosen. Means if this conditional expression results true, then this expression will be assigned to the target signal. And if the conditional expression is false, then whatever written here, this will be assigned to the target signal. We discussed this with the example. So let us take this example. A is equal to A is equal to B less than C. So this is the conditional expression. So this is the conditional expression. Then question mark. After this D plus 5. This is the true expression. Colon D plus 2. This is the false expression. So what will happen? B less than C will be evaluated. If it is true, then D plus 5, this value will be assigned to A. And if B less than C is false, then this value D plus 2 will be assigned to A. Right? So in this way, in one expression itself, you can assign either the true expression or false expression depending upon the conditional expression, right? So same thing is written. If B is less than C, the value of A will be D plus 5. Else, A will have the value D plus 2. So this conditional operator can be used both in continuous assignment statement, right, and in procedural statement inside an always block. So this type of conditional operator you can use in data flow model where you use assign statement, right? So where we use assignment statement, there we can use conditional operator. Or if we are using procedural statement, that is if we are using the statement inside always block, always at the rate. So after this, if we are having some statement, so here also we can use this conditional operator. We will see another example. Now here a 2:1 multiplexer specified using conditional operator. Now suppose there is one, we have to design one multiplexer. Suppose this is a multiplexer. This is 2:1 multiplexer having two inputs, one output, and inputs are this is suppose W0, this is W1, this is the output F, and there is a select line S, right? So here the operation is this is input number 0 of multiplexer, this is input number 1, right? So the operation is, if select pin S is 0, if S is 0, then W0 will be assigned to F, and if S is 1, then W1 will be assigned to F. So to perform this logic, we have written this code module and module, and in between I have written this code MUX221. This is the name of this module. Then it has four ports: W0, W1, S, F. Now input ports are W0, W1 and S. They are the input port, right? So you see here we have written the colon. With this statement you have to semicolon. You have to terminate the statement by semicolon. By declaring the input port, you terminate this statement again by semicolon, then you declare the output port. Output port is F. Terminate this statement by semicolon. And here I am using the assign statements. That's why I have taken the assign keyword. So this is an example of data flow model. And what I have written, F is equal to S, this question mark, W1 colon W0. So this X is conditional. It is conditional expression. Okay. So I have written S. This means and okay. Now here see this W1. This is the true expression. And W naught is false expression. So if S is true, or if S is equal to 1, right? In both of these cases, so true means 1. If S is 1, then W1 will be assigned to, then W1 will be assigned to F. So see here what operation we want. If S is 1, then W1 should be assigned to F. And if S is 0, then this false expression, which is W0, it will be assigned to F. So if this, see this condition, if S is 0, then W0 will be assigned to F. So in this way, this statement models are 2:1 multiplexer. Okay, so here in this way we can use the conditional operator. Now another operator is replication operator. This operator allows repeated concatenation of the same vector. So repetitive concatenation of the same vector is allowed by using replication operator. So number of times, how many number of times the particular operand will repeat, that will also be given in the operator. So the symbol of this operator is, there is two curly brackets, right? There are, this is one curly bracket set, and inside this there is another curly bracket set, and any number of operands are allowed. So we'll see the example. So this example one, so here it is written inside the curly bracket, first I have written 3, right? So this 3 is my you can write in this way, 3 A so here this 3 is my operand number 1, and this A is my operand number 2. So here what will happen, the operand A will be repeated 3 times. Okay, let us assume operator A, this operand A is a 3-bit vector, right? Let us assume it is a 3-bit vector. So now if I write this statement 3 and inside curly bracket 3, so whatever I have written this inside the curly bracket A, this operand will be repeated 3 times. So result will be A, A, A. If one A is 3 bit, so here 9 bit will be created, right? 9 bit vector will be created, right? For this first A, 3 bits, for second A, 3 bits, and for third A, 3 bits. So 9 bit vector will be created. We will see another example. Now here inside the curly bracket I have written this 4. So this 4 is one operand, and inside the another curly bracket is there. Here I have written 2 tick B, and this means that 2 bit binary value can be mentioned. So I have mentioned 2 bit binary value 10. So now what will happen? This 10 will be repeated 4 times. Will be, so replication, same value 10 will be repeated 4 times. So in this way, 10 10 10 10. So this is one time, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. 4 times 10 will be repeated. So finally you will get 8 bit vector, and that vector will be having a value 10 10 10 10 10. So it results the 8 bit vector 10 10 10 10 10. We'll see another example. Now in this example you can see, now inside the curly bracket what is done, you see here, this is the first set of operands. Here the meaning of this is A is repeated 2 times, means A and A is repeated 2 times. Then after comma we mentioned 3 within and curly bracket B. This means B is repeated 3 times. So B, B, B. In this way, this will be the result. If A is a 3 bit number and B is a 3 bit number, so total how many bit vector is created? So with 1A 3 bit, with 2A 3 bit, with B 3 bit, 3 bit, 3 bit. So total 15 bit vector will be created by using this replication operator. So now we have completed the discussions on all the operators.